Dr. Ogilvy was the superintendent who had been, I think, my first teacher evaluator. And then maybe a week or two later, we met over in your office and decided that that was what we would do. Head coaching is a little bit like quarterbacking. I've experienced both of those. You get way too much credit when things go well because there's a whole lot of people doing a whole lot of stuff to make you look good. Sometimes you get a little more of the heat when things don't go well, but it is far outweighed by all the good things that happen when you're in charge. And so I've been blessed to have worked with some great men. Many of them are standing back here for the incredible, incredible journey of coaching that I've got to be on for the last 40 years. Manning and Mike Little and Cotton Wade and Tommy Knowles and Bill DeFee and Ron Lancaster and you learn how to coach or you die. You learn how to do it better or you won't survive.
Here with Antonio Graham, the head. Let me shake your hand, head coach.
Yes, sir.
How I feel?
Feel good, man. First of all, I never thought I'd be a head coach. I'm getting interviewed by one of my players, so that's what's up right there, man.
Man, that's full circle, man.
Yeah, like, no doubt.
Like,
no doubt.
I was telling LT this earlier, but he got to come see this, man. I remember when you first got the job in Indy. Mm-hmm. He was just a quiet, cool dude.
Yeah.
But every time you said something, it stuck. Like, that's anytime right. You said anything to anybody, they had to respect it and they had to implement it on the spot.
Yeah, I appreciate that.
I used to think you was like a dog whistle. Like, only real dogs can hear your whistle, you know what I mean?
Right,
like,
no doubt.
You was talking to real ones.
Yeah.
Like I told LT, like linebackers, every time I've seen you coach somebody, you touch them, you make them a better person, make them a better player, and they see you as a head coach. I was
young then. I was probably about 24, fresh out of college.
Mike Thomas.
Shut up.
You know what I mean? Now you're the head coach.
Yeah.
I know you said earlier, ain't no such thing as pressure. Like, you live in pressure.
Yeah, well, I mean, being a minority, it's always pressure, right?
Are you the first black head coach at Owasso Union, Jinx, or Bixby?
Yes. Yes. But that's not pressure, though.
Dang.
Pressure is just continue to be a good example for my dogs and making sure that, you know, I go support my homeboy consistent, you know, and that's pressure because a lot of people don't do things consistent. You know what I'm saying? So me always holding Stefan accountable because he's the GOAT, right?
Yeah.
And so I'm always on his butt about, hey, you need to go freaking make yourself a big deal. That's pressure, but you got to be able to handle that, you know what I'm saying? So. And be consistent about it. So I'm not worried about this. It's gonna take care of itself. So
what do the Owasso Rams got in store for spring?
Bunch of we're gonna have a good time, man. And we're gonna raise good young men first. And good boy. But we're gonna be some dogs too. And so and we're gonna have our own identity. And we're gonna be it's gonna be something special. So.
Man, this is a surreal moment. They ain't gonna know, but like to see, like I would vividly remember you walking in, like, yeah, this is Coach Graham. I'm like,
yeah.
Who is this? Then
yeah.
He on the wall, he got tackles, records, and all that. Now, yeah. You're the Don Dada, man. Congratulations.
Appreciate you, man. Thank you for your time, Dad.
Hey, go get her. Hey,